it's Chloe and we're back with another video. You guys, I'm so excited because Married at First Sight is officially back, okay? Forget all those matchmaking specials or whatever, okay? We had the first premiere, the 3-hour episode, where we get to meet our couples, let them tell their families and friends that they're getting married, okay? See their reaction, and then they get to go out, pick their dresses, their tux. They also get to have a bachelorette and a bachelor party, and then doom, 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 it's the big day. Everyone gets married, okay? This episode, we got one wedding, and I feel like that's, that's promising. That's promising. Hopefully, it only take us 2 more episodes to get through these weddings, because I'm ready to get to some marriages, okay? The weddings is the fluff, okay? But that's our first impression of if we think these couples are going to make it or not, and see where this goes. But y'all already know that it don't go down until we hit the honeymoons, okay? When we hit the honeymoons, it goes down. Besides last season, because last season was like, you know, an exception because that junk popped off at the weddings, okay? It just popped off at the weddings dealing with Chris Williams, okay? But anyway, let's leave him in the past where he at. No more addressing him. Let's move on. Now, the first couple we get to see is Gil and Myla. Now, I don't know if I said her name right, but I will get it right as the season go on. Y'all, don't come for me. Just don't come for me. So Gil sits down with his friends and he tells them, like, I'm engaged. And they like, what? When? How? He like, I don't know. I'm engaged. And I'm like, you know exactly how you got here, Gil. You signed up and Married at First Sight. You took all the questions. You did all them interviews, okay? You know how you got here. Don't talk about something you don't know, but he don't know, but he getting married, y'all, okay? He's a fighter, and he has no problems getting girls. And I was like, I can tell he's a little handsome, okay? Nice built, okay? A little sexy or whatever. Some guy, so I can see why he doesn't have a problem getting girls, okay? But he says that his job is very demanding and his hours, sometimes he works 24-hour shifts, so you know it's kind of hard to keep up that dating life, I would assume, okay? He's Colombian and he likes to salsa dance, okay? But the one thing about Gil that stood out to me the most is his trauma, okay? He lost his father to a home invasion and he lost his ability to fully trust someone. And for me, I feel like that's a big, big issue when you come on Married at First Sight if you did not go to therapy previously to handle that trauma. Because if you can't trust, how do you expect to have a successful marriage? So I'm hoping that he can let his walls down, his guards down, and let Myla in, okay? Hopefully, she wants to step into it because she's a piece of work, but we ain't at her yet. We still talking about Gil, okay? Willie says, like, I think this is a prank. Is this a prank? Like, what are you doing? Why is he doing this? Is it somebody going to pop out? It's a prank? And no, Willie, it's not a prank. Gil is getting married at first sight. I know only crazy people do this, so you might as well just add him to that category of crazy people, okay? So they asked him, like, what if you're not attracted to her? What if you're not attracted to her? He was like, but what if she's not attracted to me? And I was like, ding, 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 ding. Let's get into it, y'all. Let's get over to Dagwon, Myla. Let's get over to her because homegirl is a piece of work. Anyway. So she goes to sit down with her friends, but like she said in her little confessional moment, she's tired of third wheeling, okay? She's tired of being the third wheel. She's tired of like being the friend who ain't got nobody. Everybody got a man and a husband and a dog and a cat, and she just over there by herself, okay? So she's ready to settle down, okay? We find out that she does a lot of self-care, okay? She does a lot of self-care, okay? Homegirl got like Botox. She get her lashes done all the time. Her skin regimen is like 5 hours long. Okay, homegirl does a lot of self-care, but that comes from her upbringing, okay? She was raised up very poor. She didn't have a lot of money. So for her, she just wants to take care of herself and she never wants to be in that position where she can't do those things for herself. So she takes a lot of pride in her physical appearance. And I'm like, baggage, okay? Once again, I keep telling y'all, it's baggage, it's baggage, it's baggage, because she's taking that insecurity of being broke and she's she's presenting it on the outside, okay? She feels as though she has to look a certain type of way in order for people to see who she really is, okay? Because being broke made her feel like she wasn't worthy, okay? And I'm like, being broke should not ever make you feel like you're not worthy. If you have to go do the Botox and you have to do all the extra stuff to make yourself feel worthy, you need to go talk to somebody, y'all. Therapy is real. There's a reason we have therapists, okay? Go see them, talk to them, figure it out. But anyway, when she tells them that she's getting married, they're like, oh, wow, oh, that's crazy. That's a lot, okay? So like, what does he do? And she's like, I don't really know what he does. I'm gonna have to find out when I meet him, okay? And she tells them that she has a short list of things that she wants in a man, okay? She wants him to be tall, okay? Dark, okay? Bearded. Because he's not bearded. And the one thing she doesn't really want is the bald guy. And I said, not only did they give this woman a bald guy, he ain't got no beard. But you guys, hear me out. Hear me out. 2 seconds, okay? Listen. Like I just said, she uses her outer appearance to, like, you know, cope with her insecurities. And I think that if she can see Gil for who he really is and not focus so much on not having a beard and not focus so much on not having some hair, she might actually be able to understand why they would match. I just hope homegirl don't be like, I'm so unattracted that I just can't go through with the process. Because we know when people are unattracted to these people, okay, they just can't go through with the process the way it's supposed to be going through with, okay? But let's pray and see how that goes. Now, her friends tell her that she's going to have to learn how to compromise, but she feels like it's her way or no way. I was sitting here like, girl, already we got to deal with you. I got my eye on her, y'all. I got my eye on her. But she's not willing to, you know, shift her lifestyle. She's going to go get her lashes done, her Botox done. She's going to wear matching outfits to the gym every single day of her life. And if he can't get with it, he can get lost, apparently. Because she said what she said, and that's what it sounds like she said. But anyway, y'all, let's just move on. When Pastor Cal sits there and try to explain to us, okay, why he would match, why they're a good match, I was like, really, Pastor Cal? That was so generic, okay? Oh, they have cultural similarities. They grew up similar. Y'all been doing this to these people who have similarities growing up, okay? Cultural connections, and it didn't work out, okay? If you want to take a hint, let's go to like Bree and Vincent, okay? They didn't have cultural similarities, but for some reason, it's working for them. So maybe past insight from last couples might work if you use it. But I don't think you're doing that. I don't think so. This is surely a case of opposites attract. Just saying, just my opinion. Now anyway, let's get over to Michaela and Zach, y'all. Zach goes to tell his parents and he's nervous because his parents are not really here for getting married at first sight. And I was like, because they've been watching all these seasons and they know that you're about to get roasted on national television by all of us. Okay, the reviewers of the show, the people in the chat, they know that this is never a good idea if you're not tough. So they're not really with it, but he's nervous, okay? He tells his dad and he tells his family and they're like, Why would you do this? Like, why? I'm confused. Like, why? But mom wants him to know, okay? Marriage is more than just love because he's just like, I want someone to love, okay? I want to be in love. She's like, marriage is a decision that you make every day to be committed. It's not just about love. And I was like, ding, 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 mom, got it right. You guys, these people just be like, oh, I love love. I want love, okay? Everybody wants word love, but are you willing to put in the work? That is the question that needs to be answered. And we will find out in the next, what, 16 weeks? Okay. But Zach is still ready to just, you know, play the piano for someone. He doesn't want to play the piano for no one anymore. And he said something that just made me cringe a little bit. He says that love will complete him. And I just sat there and said, no, it will not. You have to be whole in order to love someone. You have to love yourself wholeheartedly. Be complete with you. So that you can give them what they need. And he he's the youngest, y'all, so I'm a little concerned about Zach. Okay, but anyway, he says he's ready to fall in love for the first and the last time. And y'all know I don't have a problem with the person never being in love. I feel like it's a clean slate. It's an even playing field when you've never been in love, because you get the chance to experience it for the first time and hopefully the last time, like Zach said, okay? So we know his father is a no for him, okay? Dad was like, no, why, Zach, why, okay? Mom is just like, getting a little emotional because she just don't want her son to end up with no ransom, okay? Like, Zach, we raised you better than this, okay? That's what I got for them. It was like, we raised you better than this, but you didn't learn from us. They just want some sane kids, because obviously Zach isn't acting sane. He's acting very insane, okay? Y'all, I just really feel like Zach may not be mature enough for this, but let's just see how it plays out. But anyway, let's get over to Michaela, y'all. Now, Michaela is sitting down with her family, and I must say, she's beautiful. She's beautiful, and I want her to smile all day. Like, don't stop smiling, girl. Just smile. Smile. When you're not talking, just sit there like this. Because her smile is beautiful, okay? Even the women in her family, they're all beautiful. I was like, oh, okay. It's in the genetics, okay? It's in the genes. You better work it, okay? But anyway, so in her little, you know, confessional scene, I guess while we were getting to know her, we find out that she just wants to get married, okay? It kind of sounds like she kind of took the lazy way out, like she didn't really put that much work in or whatever the case may be. She just wanted somebody to go find her a man, so that's what she did, okay? We do find out that she was homeless at one point in life, and she had a rough childhood growing up, okay? She wants us to know that she's refined and she's from the hood. I said, okay, sounds like me. Okay, refined and from the hood, okay? I like Michaela. I just feel like somehow, some way, we kind of like connected, okay? Through the TV, we kind of connected this episode. But anyway, she lost her father. And you guys, I'm just sitting here like, oh my God, like I can't imagine. But anyway, she lost her father, and she brings up a memory of how her hood on her car kind of flew off one time, and she called him, and he came and rescued her. And that's what she wants in her husband. She wants him to always be there for her and to rescue her when she needs him. And it's beautiful. It's so fairy tale-ish, but it's reality in some people's cases, you know. And to have someone to cherish you and willing to come running to you at the drop of a dime is a gift from God. So when you get someone like your mom and your father and your siblings and your wives and your husbands, you cherish them and you appreciate them for that, okay? She sits down, she finally tells her family that she's getting married. And they are like really happy. Like they start crying and they're emotional. And I'm like, okay, this is nice. This is sweet, okay? We found out that Michaela has never been in love either. And I'm like, oh, clean slate. But I kind of could figure that. You want to know why? Because she never really put in the work to be dating, okay? If you listen to her past story, it doesn't sound like she was really out there looking for love. It's kind of like she just got to the point where I'm tired of like just, you know, dealing with these people. You guys find me a man, okay? And that's what happened. And I talked about that when I was introducing the couples to you guys, that she just said that she was a realtor, and she opened the next chapter to so many people's life by, you know, presenting them with their houses. And now she wants someone to do that for her. So I feel as though she didn't ever really put in the work, okay? I feel like if she would have really put in the work, she probably could have snagged her man on her own. But homegirl didn't want to do it. She was lazy about it. She came on Married at First Sight, and now she's going to get her husband, okay? And I'm happy for her, okay? That's why I'm not surprised that she's never been in love, okay? Pastor Cal tell us that Michaela needs someone patient, and that is Zach. And Zach needs someone full of excitement, and that is Michaela. And y'all, I can definitely tell that Michaela is full of excitement. So far, she's my favorite, just letting you guys know. But anyway, let's get over to Bo and Johnny. Bo and Johnny really, really stole my heart. This episode is so weird. Okay, let's just do it. We're not there yet. Let's see. So Bo tells his friends that he's getting married at first sight, and they just like, oh, great, let's toast to that, okay? So then we get to his little confessional. We learn that he has like a big case of OCD, okay? And he's very attracted to hygiene, okay? If you can clean yourself all day long, he will love you long time, okay? But he's been very, very picky with the women that he picks, okay? He goes on all types of dating apps and he's looking for women. He's looking for love. He's trying to find it out there, okay? But it's just not coming to him. It's not happening the way he wanted to happen. And that's how he ended up here on Married at First Sight. But y'all, I'm a little concerned when it comes to Johnny, because Johnny wants a woman who is way more attracted to him than he is to her. He wants the woman to take the lead. He wants the woman to tell him that she loves him first. He wants her to be clingy. He wants her to be all up on him, okay? All up on him. And I'm just sitting here trying to figure out, what kind of past did you have, Johnny, that you want a woman to be so clingy over you? Did you get cheated on? Because what else would you want that, you know, that clutch on you so tight? He needs it. He wants it. He craves it. And I don't know if Bo's the type of girl that's going to give it to him, but we will have to find out. But anyway, so his friends say, what if she's more controlling than you are? And I say, ding, 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 ding. You guys are asking all the right questions tonight, because, yeah, she might be. But anyway, he says, listen, I'm willing to let go of some of that control. And just by me doing this experiment, it's me letting go of some of that control. So we'll just have to see where this takes us, okay? He does know that his mom will support him, but he's not too sure of his father. And y'all, we gonna get there. Let's get over to Bao. Now, Bao is, you know, sitting down with her brothers. And she tells her that Dr. Pepper ambushed her. I said, Dr. Pepper ain't ambushed you, girl. You signed up for this. You ambushed Dr. Pepper. Okay? She wants us to know that she uses Excel spreadsheets for everything. And I was like, girl, we don't need to know that. Nobody cares. But anyway, she grew up very, very poor. And she was very ashamed of the fact that she was poor. She was very ashamed of the fact that where she lived. And she's feeling very lonely at this point in her life because she has no one to share, you know, good and bad news with. She says, with big risks may potentially come big rewards, and that may be her husband. And I was sitting there like, I hope for you, Bao. I hope, okay? Her brothers are excited that now they don't have to, you know, take care of her anymore. They can hand her off to someone else. But they really do hope that, you know, she can learn how to be reasonable, because she's very hot-headed. And I can see why they would say that she's very hot-headed. But we'll get to that when we get to the weddings. Anyway, let's get through Brett and Ryan, y'all, because we got to get through these people. How many more couples we got after this? Hold on. This the last one. Good. Okay, so anyway, we found out that Ryan is a serial dater, okay? He's been dating maybe 50 plus people. And I was like, ooh, he's out here just, you know, trying to find him a woman, okay? He's not going to stop at any measures to find his woman, okay? He can't even go back to certain states he claimed. I was like, ooh, now I can't go back to certain states, Ryan. And then y'all know, sometimes I look at Ryan, I'm just like, never mind. Anyway, but he has made a big change in his life because he lost his best friend 18 months ago. So his insight, he has a different outlook on life at this point. He's ready to settle down. He's ready to have children. And I can get it. Sometimes, you know, you lose something so valuable and so precious that I think he's looking to maybe fill a void. And I'm not saying that maybe he's looking to, like, you know, get a wife because he misses his best friend. But if he's missing that connection, he may just really be trying to fill a void, y'all. And it just hit me. I could be wrong, but we're here. So let's go through. In his confessional, he seems very depressed. I'm telling you. Something about Ryan, therapy. Okay? I don't think I said three or four people so far may need therapy. Yeah. So Ryan is more concerned about telling his sister than his parents, okay? Because his sister is the one that's going to get him to a straight no chaser. And usually his parents kind of just hop on whatever train she's on. And, you know, when he tells them that he's getting married, the sister looks very unhappy about that situation. And so does the parents. But I'm going to tell you why I feel like the sister feels very unhappy. Because she's used to, like, living with him. She's used to cooking for him. She's used to doing things for him that she will no longer have to do. That place that she has been filling in for him, she won't have that place anymore. before someone's going to step in and take it. So I feel like she might be a little bitter towards the fact that, you know, she's going to lose her little brother in some sense. Or is it her big brother? I don't know. Her brother overall, right? But the family just looks uncomfortable. Even though they try to, like, laugh it off and joke a little bit, it just seems very uncomfortable. Like, they really don't approve of this situation whatsoever. Okay, and I feel like there may be a little bit of an issue when it comes to the sister down the line. I don't know. I just say I feel like, but we'll have to see. Now, anyway, y'all, let's get over to Brett. I don't know why her name is Brett. I've never met a female Brett, but hey, that's her name. And her hair is beautiful. The color is stunning on her, okay? My daughter was like, okay, hair. I said, yes, okay, hair. Hair look really nice, okay? She's sitting down with her friends, and she's like, what y'all gonna be doing in 2 weeks? And it was like, why? She was like, oh, because I'm getting married in 2 weeks. And they're like, oh my God, yes, it's so exciting for you. I'm so happy for you. Oh my God. Everyone is like, you know, really excited for her. They're really happy for her. And I was like, it's so cute, okay? So we find out that Brett has not been dating. She hasn't been dating, talking, or getting laid with anyone in the last 2 years. And I say, no dating, no talking, no getting laid. Why? Girl, you said you wanted a husband. Why? Why you not out here looking for him? Wait, never mind. Okay, never mind. But anyway, she said she looked at her parents' marriage and she just loved how they still love spending time with each other and just enjoying each other's company after so many years. And she really wants that. She's looking for that person to watch TV with her, even though he might not like what she's watching. And I was like, that's so true, y'all, because my husband get on my nerve when he be watching Animal Planet and I just be wanting to turn. But I just watch it with him. And sometimes I get into it too, okay? I'm just saying. Anyway, her friends want her to know that, you know, it's not all fairy tales and dreams, okay? But she is scared of getting her heart broken. And I'm like, girl, then why did you come on Married at First Sight? Have you not watched all the seasons, honey? Have you not did your research or your homework? Because there's a lot of broken hearts that come out of these seasons, just saying. Okay, but anyway, oh, you guys, there is one more couple. I thought we got through them, but no, we got one more, okay? Rachel and Jose. So Rachel's gonna sit down with her friends and her mom, and you know, she tells them, like, you know, if I get matched, I'm gonna be marrying a stranger. And they're like, yeah, I guess that's the idea of what Married at First Sight is, Rachel. We got that part, okay? But we do learn about Rachel that she has lost over 35 pounds in the last 9 months. So homegirl is feeling sexy on the outside, okay? She says, but she feels alone, okay? Her last relationship lasted for about 6 months. Her last relationship was about 6 months ago, and you know, he cheated on her, and it just didn't work out, okay? But she always enjoyed being in a relationship. But the one flaw that she has is that she molds herself to the guy, okay? But she's not that person anymore. She's not going to conform to whoever she's dating. And I feel like that's a lie. That's a lie. That's a lie. I don't know if you can really change that much about yourself in 6 months if you haven't really been dating anyone since the last relationship, okay? I feel like she's going to be the people pleaser and try to be who her husband wants her to be instead of just being her. She says she isn't, but I have a feeling she will be. Okay. So when she tells them that she's getting married, they're like, oh, wow. But what if they don't like, what if he don't like you? You still going to live with him? They out there throwing out all the worst scenarios that could possibly happen. Okay. They was like, yeah, if he's not attracted to you, what if he don't want to live with you? And she's like, I'm going to still go through with the process how I'm supposed to. I'm still going to live with the man. I'm going to hope he falls into traction with me. I don't know. Homegirl was sending like, well, dang. I was like, dang. They ain't got nothing positive to say. They brought up every bad scenario that ever happened on Married at First Sight to her attention. Okay? They was doing their homework. They was doing the research. I'll tell you that much. But anyway, they like, just be honest with who you are and don't accommodate yourselves for someone else. And I said, we know. We know, Brett. Girl, I hope you know who you are. See, therapy. We need to get the girl in some therapy, okay? Because we need to make sure that she's strong in who she is and she's not going to change who she is for anyone else, because that's probably what led the last relationship to go down the drain. She was putting on a fake. She was being a fraud. She wasn't being herself. She was just accommodating. And y'all, therapy is real. Just go to one. Go to a therapist somewhere. I need one. We all need one. Anyway, let's move on. So Jose is up next to tell his family that he's getting married in the next 2 weeks. He is very successful. He has 2 homes, no loans, no debt. Homeboy is coasting. He's living the life, okay? The life of a lot of us Americans that want that life. No debt, no loans, 2 houses, okay? We need that. Where you find that at? How you do that? Give us a lesson, a class, or something, okay? That's what we need. You need not to be on Married at First Sight. You need to be giving us a lecture on how to clear up our lives. He has very high standards. He's very picky, and he doesn't want a cat woman, okay? He wants a woman who's going to bring something to the table, okay? You need to be just as driven as I am, okay? You need to get your credit together. You need to get your loans paid off, your debt paid off, because I'm not going to do it for you. Okay? But, yeah, that's Jose, y'all. So we found out that his parents end up getting divorced, and so for him, it's very important to have trust in his marriage. And I said that's very important for everyone. We all need to have trust in our marriages, or it's not going to work. It's not going to be a successful marriage. But he does feel like divorce would make him feel like a failure. So he's willing to put in a fight and give it his all, 110%. So you guys, Johnny finally calls his father to tell him that he is getting married at first sight. Now you guys, at first I was like, here they go with the dramatic music, being all extra. But honey, when they told us that his father was not here for it, okay? He does not support him whatsoever. And he declined to actually even being filmed, even voice, even anything. I said, oh, we needed that dramatic music. Because this is real. Poor Johnny. Johnny is very emotional. And he's taking it very hard. And he's like crying. And I'm like, see, listen. Therapy. I don't know how you're going to be, you know, even though he was raised by his parent, his mother, you know, and his family, you know, his mother's side of the family. He was raised with, you know, his cousins, like siblings. He's always going to wish that his father was there and supporting him in some type of way. And I don't know how this will affect him, especially because he's so family orientated. So I'm hoping that this works out when it comes to the father side, because I could see his father actually even just disowning him altogether, not wanting nothing to do with him or Val. And I don't know how that's going to make Johnny feel. And I don't know how that's going to make Val feel. So at this point, y'all, it's just up in the air, honey. But I felt so bad for Johnny. It was very emotional. And like to see him like break down like that, I was just like, poor Johnny. And it's nothing we can do but hope that your father comes around. Sometimes the parents come around. You never know. You might actually fall in love with Val, be happy, and you know, everything goes great, and then he finally comes around. You might have that whole perfect family dynamic that you want. Let's just hope for the best. Fingers crossed, okay? But you guys, I'm not gonna lie. After last season, that scene gave me the drama that I like to see from Married at First Sight. Not saying I like the fact that his father didn't agree, but that is the type of realness, raw emotion, drama that we expect when you bring two people together to marry at first sight. We expect for the families to not agree. We expect for there to be a different dynamics when it comes to, you know, cultures and things like that. So for that, I can appreciate, you know, the rawness of it. And it doesn't seem fake or scripted to the point where, you know, people having babies with other people and things like that. You know what I mean? You know what I mean. But anyway, now it's time for all the men to meet up and all the women to meet up so they can figure out who's just as crazy as them to actually go on Married at First Sight. Y'all, these people get on my nerve. Already, let's get into the shenanigans. The men are over there talking about how they don't want no IG models, okay? She gotta have less than 1,000 followers because the IG models, don't get me wrong, are baddies or whatever, but it's just too much. It's just too much. They want a regular, degla, smegla girl. And I was like, oh, okay, so let me get this right. It's okay for y'all to look at the Instagram models and like the pictures, okay, and slide in ADMs, but you don't want your wife to be that? Okay. Mm-hmm. You got all these women out there changing themselves to look like these IG models when these not even the women that the men want. But those are the women that the men go after. This is why you're not married now, I should say. Guys. Look at me. be in my feelings for no reason. But anyway, let's keep going. So, Johnny talks about how he wants a clingy girl, of course, okay? And they how he wants her to be low-key psychopathic. I say, ooh, child, be careful what you ask for. Be careful what you ask for, Johnny. But anyway, the women are talking, and they're talking about self-care, okay? And but they do say a lot of them bring up the concern that they don't want to come out of this thing broken. And I was like, sounds like a Paige situation. Yeah, y'all saw it last season. Y'all don't want to come out as being broke down, okay? You don't want to play a fool. And I was just like, listen, whenever you go on Married at First Sight, there's a chance that you will come out of this broken. You may discover some things about yourself and build yourself back up, honey. But when you put your heart on the line, there's a chance it will get broke. The men are talking about how they want a confident woman, you know, someone who's secure in themselves. And I was like, wow, the woman is just talking about being broken down by y'all, okay? Johnny brings up the fact that Ryan looks worn out. And I said, that man looked tired. I told y'all, he just looks sad and depressed for some reason. I need some expression, some emotion, some excitement, some something from Ryan, okay? So I'm looking forward to his wedding just to see if I can get a glimpse of who he really is, because this episode wasn't doing it for me. It just wasn't. So most of the women are down for the kisses, and so are the men. So hopefully we have some, you know, smooches going on during these weddings, okay? But what I did learn from this is that Michaela had a fun buddy, okay? Because when they were talking about how long it's been since they actually had, you know, intimacy, okay? Homegirl was like, it hasn't been as long as you, girl. Not 2 years, okay? Kind of like I had to tell him the other night, it's over, I'm engaged. I was like, okay, Michaela, out here living your best life, sis. She just cut off her fun buddy, honey. She cut him off. Once she found out that she was engaged, she was like, okay, I'm gonna cut him off now. It's official. I wasn't gonna stop in the process because, honey, sis got knees. I like Michaela. I feel like she's me. I'm sorry. She just is. So, y'all, now it's time for the bachelorette and the bachelor parties. I'm not gonna go into the wedding gowns, y'all. I just feel like it's just too much, okay? We'll talk about the wedding gowns as the weddings go. We'll talk about the tux as the weddings go. But let's just get to this bachelorette and this bachelor party. Now, you guys, they're both at strip clubs, okay? The men don't seem like they was having too much fun. At one point, they were sitting there talking or whatever. But on the other side, where the women are, honey, the women are getting down. Or should I say, Michaela is getting down. Michaela was dropping it like it was hot, okay? She was backing it up, okay? She was twirling it around, okay? She was dipping it low, bringing it up slow, all that, okay? Homegirl was having fun. Time of her life, and I was here for it, okay? She is about to be married. She's gonna live it up, and she definitely lived it up, okay? Val was over there, you know. Val was over there, you know, riding the bull until she fell off, okay? They was having so much fun. We do find out that, you know, Val, Michaela is willing to smash if she's attracted to Zach. She's willing to smash. Okay, now, let's see how that goes, okay? A lot of things happened at this bachelorette party, in the bachelor party, but the men would, but then the men started opening up, okay? And they throwing the dollars and getting the dances and dancing with the strippers. And I was just saying, like, they looked like they was having a good time, okay? Of course, some of them was a little whack. There's always one or two that's like turned up, okay? Val was turned up, Johnny was turned up, Michaela was turned up, Zach was a little turned up, Gil was a little turned up, everybody else was a little turned-ish, okay? But overall, they looked like they had a good time, y'all. And I was here because ain't nobody gonna ever tell but for me, okay? No one's gonna top Bennett and the Big Booty Stripper from that season, okay? Until I see another Big Booty Stripper and Bennett. Michaela's close, okay? But no one's gonna top it for me yet, okay? I'm just saying. Now, anyway, it's the wedding days, you guys. Everybody's waking up, everybody's excited, they're nervous, they're anxious, they're just ready, okay? Let's just start this new chapter in our lives. And I'm here to, you know, go on this ride. I'm excited, okay? The first wedding is Val and Johnny, you guys. And Johnny hopes that Val thinks that he looks damn good. And, you know, Val just hopes that he's nerdy. And I was like, okay, let's get into it, okay? So Val's on the phone with one of her friends, and she's just like, I'm so nervous. Like, I hope he's the right fit for me. I hope he's the right fit for my family. And her friend was like, stop being a control freak and take that stick up out your ass. I said, okay. Tell her how it is, friend. Tell her how it is, because the friend... looking, okay? If that's one thing, I guess if you're going to tell us something, she's willing to take it as long as it's true, okay? Johnny's letting his friends know that he's going to need them a lot more today. He's going to lean on them a lot more today than probably any other day of his life, okay? When Belle comes out in her dress, you guys, it's so beautiful. It is so classic. And that little like shawl robe-ish thingy, that, you know, train of and it had the like detailed diamonds like right here on the, it was beautiful. I loved it. The simplicity of the makeup, the hair, the jewelry, the dress spoke for it. It was beautiful. I absolutely loved it. I don't care what y'all think. I said what I said, okay? Now, they start exchanging gifts. And when Johnny gets his card and his gift, okay, he reads the note and she's like, I wrote this, you know, while I was eating the cheeseburger. Hope you have a good day. You know, she's making jokes of, like, with sympathy, you know, you're stuck with me. You know, just little laughing, you know, joking things. And, you know, Johnny is like, oh, I love her. I like this already. She's willing to laugh for herself. Like, that just shows me a lot. I'm excited. And it went over well with Johnny. But y'all, did not go over well with Belle. Because when Belle sat there, and she opened up her gift and she read her long letter after she didn't wrote half of a paragraph. He wrote a whole page, okay? She said, he said to her, I hope you're a big sports fan. And she instantly dried up. She instantly got turned off because she doesn't do good with sports fans. She doesn't have a good track record with them whatsoever, okay? She opens up the gift. It's a jersey. Red flag. She opens up another gift. It's the jersey. Another red flag. She's disappointed. She's upset. She is mad. Because, like, why would they? This is wrong. This can't be right. Like, he likes sports? Why? Why would anyone like sports? It's the worst thing in the whole entire world. I work with scientists. I work with people who cure cancer. And they don't like sports. So if he likes sports, he must be a bro. And I don't want a bro. I said dramatic much? Dramatic much? Sis, calm down. Calm. If that's your red flag, whoo child, you got a lot to learn about marriage. I'm just saying, if that's your red flag. Johnny's pacing back and forth. Okay, he's excited, he's nervous, he's anxious. Okay, he's standing at the altar, and you know, Belle's taking a long time to come. He's like, what if she don't show up? What if she don't show up? Belle's sitting there, you know, drinking her wine and, you know, her champagne, and she's just like so disappointed and she's so upset. And I was like, sis, you signed the contract, so you gotta walk down the aisle, period. So y'all can sit here with the dramatics if you want. We already know you're walking down the aisle, so get up and let's go. So she gets up, you guys, and when she walks out, Johnny's face kind of lit up. Her face, she smiled. And she was like, I know him. And he was like, oh my God. And she was like, it's Johnny. And all she kept saying was like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. So like, y'all, I'm like, do you like, y'all, is this good or bad? I don't know. Somebody let me know, is this good or bad? Because I'm confused. I don't know if I should be happy, sad, mad, confused. But overall, y'all, it turned out that I'm assuming it was a good thing because he told her, you look beautiful. She said you are handsome. So to me, I feel like they had a natural attraction. They knew each other. They introduced themselves to each other again. Their vows were absolutely beautiful. His vows were very, you know, on point with the situation at hand. I can't stand those vows where it'd be like, you're the moon, the sunshine of my life, and you never even met the person. You're the person that I've been waiting for all my life and never met the person. Like, his vows were very relevant, and her poem was absolutely beautiful to the point where, you guys, I kind of teared up a little bit. I'm not even gonna lie, I was sitting there like, I looked at my husband like, why, do you love me? Do you feel like that about me? Y'all, he'd be like, this is why I don't like when you watch these shows, because you always want to start comparing me to these people on TV. It's TV. But anyway, their vows was absolutely beautiful. When she puts the ring on his finger, she says, you're stuck with me. And at that point, I said, it's good. It's good. It's a good thing. This is a good thing. They like each other, okay? They take their pictures. They like joking about where to put the hands. He's like, on my booty. And he's like, can I put my hand on your waist? You know, wherever you want, it's cool, okay? They kiss. They actually have a kiss at the wedding. You guys, it was beautiful. I am here for them. I am absolutely here for the two of them. They sit down and they have a conversation. We found out that they were all presidents of like the same organizations, but in two different schools. They cross paths a lot. So they kind of know who each other is, and they kind of understand why they were matched with each other. They get it. They understand it. And they're willing to, like, you know, figure this whole situation out. He says, you know, he wants to do a tea ceremony. And she was like, that's what you wanted to ask me? Because I was just about to say, I insist that we do a tea ceremony. So there we have it, you guys. Our first couple is matched and married and met each other and happy about each other. So this is a good sign so far, and I'm hoping that we can keep this going, okay? But I'm excited, you guys. I'm really nervous for Gil and Myla, because he's everything she doesn't want, and I'm a little concerned for Michaela and Zach. Yep. But you guys will have to see how this plays out. If you did not like this video, like this video. If you did not subscribe, subscribe so you could go on this journey with me for the whole season. And I'll see you guys with Put a Ring on It review tomorrow. No, Sunday. I'm going away tomorrow. We're going to hang out, family time. But Sunday, Put a Ring on It review will be up. Don't forget, like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff.